So today we're talking about the National Institute of Health, estimating as many as 450,000 Americans die every year from sudden cardiac arrest.
Common cause of death around the nation, but right here in Cleveland, the Cleveland Clinic continues to break ground with life-saving research. For more information on that, we welcome Dr. Milind Desai from the Cleveland Clinic to talk about it. First of all, doctor, thank you for stopping by. I know you're a busy man. It's always good to see you and your colleagues here. Let's just, right off the bat, when we talk about sudden cardiac arrest or sudden cardiac death, what are we talking about? Could you explain that?
So, yes, sudden cardiac arrest or sudden cardiac death, essentially it is something that happens suddenly, unexpectedly, and most common situation is it is in the context of an arrhythmia, a bad heart rhythm that is unable to sustain the blood flow to the brain and the rest of the body and unable to sustain life, and that results in death suddenly, which is not expected due to any other reason.
Can I ask a question? If you have been diagnosed with a heart murmur, mm-hmm. cause for alarm?
Well, yes and no. I mean, there's the heart murmurs ranges the full spectrum. It could be a benign, what we call a functional murmur, to something which can predict a serious disease, serious valve disease, serious cardiomyopathy. So it's a spectrum.
So you need to get it checked.
You need to get it checked, right. Absolutely.
Okay. So it sounds like one of the scariest things about this is for a lot of people that would this would happen to, they don't realize they yes. have a heart condition.
Yes, unfortunately, that is the case. A common cause of sudden cardiac death in younger individuals is what we call cardiomyopathy. Cardiomyopathy is disease of the heart. The most common is, there are multiple causes for sudden cardiac arrest, sudden cardiac death, but in younger folks, these are the ones that make a lot of noise, a lot of news. There are multiple diseases that can cause this. One of the most common and best characterized is hypertrophic cardiomyopathy, or HCM, where you see and hear about that in the context of athletes, mm-hmm. You know, soccer players or
LeBron
football.
James' son recently, do we know anything more about
we
him?
We do not know much. I mean, they have not come out publicly okay. with what the final diagnosis okay. was, so okay. I would not venture
what about the kid in Buffalo, the defensive back?
So his issue was different. He got stuck at the right time or the wrong time in his heart cycle okay. where it went into arrest. But okay. but what I'm coming at, the HCM, which is a common a common presentation, the heart muscle is thick, very thick. It has a lot of scar tissue, and that can potentially trigger arrhythmias, causing sudden cardiac death, sudden cardiac arrest.
So can we hit on the fact, again, the Cleveland Clinic has done it again. You have this gene therapy that the first person in the world has taken this now, an inhuman gene therapy. What is this, and how will it hopefully help those who have this?
Yes, so thank you. Yes. It's an excellent example of academic and industry partnership, and we are working with a company out of the Bay Area. Mm-hmm. In patients who have hypertrophic cardiomyopathy due to a specific genetic mutation, okay. This mutation, what it does, it results in not enough protein being synthesized specifically in the heart that results in all the downstream bad effects of the heart. So this gene therapy is basically utilizes an adenovirus, a benign virus from which its material is removed, and then the genetic code for this mutation, this disease mutation for hypertrophic cardiomyopathy is inserted. Basically, it is infused through a simple IV, okay. Goes into the body. Mm. DNA turns into RNA, turns into the missing protein that wow. essentially tops it off. That's the concept. Yeah. And it goes into the heart, and the expectation is that it regresses disease. So this could potentially be a one-time, if it works, we have to test it through adequate studies. If it works, this would be a one-time infusion to cure a genetically mediated disease. And that can open a whole lot of future therapies and future therapeutic options.
You seem pretty excited about it.
That's incredible.
Yeah, I think this is the frontier.
So what do you do, though, for people who don't know they have it? I mean, there still needs to be more studies done on that so that they can find out, because this only helps those who have been diagnosed.
Yes, absolutely. So in these cardiomyopathies, et cetera, the biggest problem, I think, is not that we don't have enough therapies. The biggest problem to me is that of underdiagnosis and misdiagnosis. So, you know, new imaging techniques, using machine learning, artificial intelligence, all the new things that you are hearing about, that will help us bridge that gap of increasing the diagnosis. Now, there's other things specifically in this disease that are also happening. Not just gene therapy, which is cutting edge, for a specific type of mutation. We also, Cleveland Clinic, has helped develop a precision drug for this disease in a much more broader context, not just those genetic mutation patients. In this disease, so that drug changes the fundamental structure of the heart, making the heart function more efficiently. Mm-hmm. And we ran a large clinical trial. Mm-hmm. And part of that clinical trial data got this brand new drug approved by the FDA. And now, so patients with this type of cardiomyopathy have a drug option, which we have recently shown reduces the need for heart surgery in 9 out of 10 patients.
As Natalie said, the Cleveland Clinic does it again. Doctors,
again.
Thank you so much for your time, man. Keep up the good work over there. You guys are doing a wonderful work.
Thank you very much for having me here.
Thank you, sir.